Okay, so, ja.
We can work it out together. No, it doesn't have anything to do with the PowerPoint. It's just the. Can you hear what? Eba no ji ma stop ele nsin.
Lo e sha ti ko ma lo be. O sise lo be.
O sise lo.
Se ba fe pause.
Eh? Ba fe pause just press it.
Eh yeah, pause ko si
wo e je ko ko awon.
We are discussing here with drawings from the Bible. The Bible is the book of life. Take it or leave it. You can go to the bank and then draw money on it. I assure you. The problem we have for those of us in the household of faith is that we do not marry the principles of life the way we do. All we aim on or hang on are basically the spiritual elements, And I want to assure you, if you see a mountain, and you start blah 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 blah, hardly will that mountain move from where it is. Except there are some other principles of life that you take along with you. People of the world, which I will call those. Those that have the stinking thinking, that's the worldly people. We have two kingdoms, the worldly kingdom and the kingdom, that's the church. We have the stinking thinking and we have the kingdom thinking. Now, the people of the world, most of them, or some basically, they key in. And that's the secret of some of their life, of some of them. They usually key in to the principles of life. And you see them lose on millionaires, making money, corporate environments, following the processes of principles of life. And where does it originate from? It's from the Bible. The only thing they won't do is that they will not put the stamp of the kingdom of are you following what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm running too fast. Just let me know. Because I promise you that the session will be interactive. It's your day, really. And that's the only thing I have a lot of exercises here to kick start. Because there's need for us to be in the right frame of mind before we start the session. If you're not in the right frame of mind, you might not be able to achieve anything. The issue there is not even the coaching and mentoring that we have come to discuss. It's just, like a derivative. But we must be in the right frame of mind. We must know where we are going before, we'll be able to achieve whatever we set out to achieve. So, I'm just trying to, lay the foundation for some of the things we'll be discussing. We'll discuss quite a lot today. I was talking about those people in the world. What they usually do is keep in to the principles of life. And how do I mean? Let's say, for instance, the rain will fall on everybody, irrespective of where you're coming from. Am I right?
Yes.
Whether you are a Christian, you are a Muslim, you are black, you are white, you are red, whatever, the rain will fall on you. There are some principles of life, principles of sowing and
reaping.
Most of those people, in this thinking world, I call them, or what you want, key into all these things, and it pays, you know, it gives them whatever they want. Mm-hmm. There are some organizations that, apart from the organization itself, paying a certain percentage of their earnings to maybe a fund or a charity organization or whatever, they also make sure that their staff do the same. Now tell me, if someone, you know, in that type of organization is doing well, you want to ask a question, why is it doing well? And I'm, you know, a spirit-filled, fire-spitting, Holy Ghost, you know, occupied, and filled, speaking in tongues from here to, you know, only God knows where. You understand what I'm saying? And you are having challenges. You'll be asking the question, how come? But the fact remains that some of the principles of life that we need to marry with our spirituality, we're not doing. And I think it's time that we marry the two. And by marrying the two, we will be able to achieve, you know, whatever we set out to achieve. I will start off by playing, you know, some slides, just the ones we've been saying before. I want us to take note of some of the things that you read, you know, while the evening is being played. And then, you know, later we'll come back to it, and then, you know, try and make something out of it. For instance, this one is on spirituality. He said, I give unconditionally. Do we give unconditionally? And you can see
Oprah Winfrey
there. Then he said, I'm grateful for life. Are we grateful for life? The next one said, I know where I'm here. Do we know why we're here? Do we know the reason why we exist? He said, I live with passion and purpose. Do you live with passion and purpose in whatever you do? Then he said, all good things are coming to me. I celebrate every day. Then he said, I'm connected to the higher consciousness. So I'm loved. I love myself. I focus on good things. That I'm grateful for them. I'm free to be myself. Today is the best day of my life. I'm aligned with the universe. Life has a meaning. I inspire others. I want us to take note of, you know, those words, because we'll come back to them later. And in some of the exercises we have there, you know, those are some of the things we're going to come across. You know, and it's very important for us to understand, you know, the reason why, you know, the video is being played, so that we can take note of those things. Are we being them? Are we reflecting, you know, those things that have been, you know, written? As, you know, he said, I have no judgments. That means he doesn't judge people. I see the best in everyone. We see the best in everyone. Because for us to be able to contribute effectively, to move with the wind of change that is going to move the new covenant church, then we must be able to pick some of these things, you know, that we're looking at. Being in the right, that was what I meant by being in the right frame of mind. Maybe about 10, 15, 20 miles to wherever you want to cover, you'll still be fit. But if you are not, you know, physically fit, after probably maybe 5 miles, you are panting. Can we get a car now? What do we do now? You understand what I'm saying? So there is need for us to marry all these things. Our life is filled up with series as, you know, a lot of components. And when we go into the session proper, we're going to talk about the quadrant principle. Talk about that, and that will further, you know, explain what I, you know, was trying to say previously. So I only need you to just
no pizza.
So I eat okay, anything, no fats and whatever.
All right.
I need to do this as much as I have to do. Because I smile effortlessly. Let's look at that. Do you smile effortlessly?
Oh,
ask yourself. These are, you know, staring questions. Rather come easily to me often. You know, I don't have to be pressurized before I smile. And I want to further, you know, explain that. It's stated that when you smile, the muscles relax. You are doing it. But when you frown, what happens? The muscles contract. So the muscles holding your, you know, your cheek, when you smile or when you frown, the one holding it is more than when you smile. And smiles or laugh could be contagious. You understand what I'm saying? If someone is laughing, you easily, even if you don't know why he's laughing, you tend to join the person. Or when he smiles, when people smile at you, you tend to smile back. Let's find out. Thank you.